Programming of Processor Internal Flash Memory. Programming flash memory is a key feature for embedded debugging. To get started right away, Lauterbach offers ready-to-run flash scripts. You can search for these scripts by selecting the menu file, then search for scripts. I will search for the STM32F3 internal flash script. By executing the script, a dialog-driven flash programming procedure is started. I will first open a data.dump window in a flash sector. Let's start the script. In case the script supports multiple CPUs, a second dialog window will pop up. Select here your exact CPU type. Another pop-up window will ask you if you want to program the flash memory. Select Yes if you want to proceed programming your flash. By selecting No, we'll only prepare the debugger for flash programming. We can now browse the executable to be programmed. You can see that the flash content has changed. Flash scripts are constantly updated by Lauterbach, so it is recommended not to change them. Trace32 provides mechanisms to support you here. A flash script always consists of three parts: commands for the board setup and setup of the debug communication, commands for the flash configuration, flash programming commands. To run the flash programming script without dialogs, we recommend to use the prepare only parameter, which skips the flash programming commands part of the flash script. The CPU selection can be specified, in this case, using the CPU parameter. I am going, for instance, to call the script with the following parameters. After the script ended, the flash configuration is done. The details can be inspected by selecting the menu MISC Flash Programming. Let's also open a data dump window for some flash sectors. Now, the flash programming commands have to be executed manually or in a separate script. The flash reprogram command group provides the optimum flash programming performance by only erasing non-empty flash sectors and only programming sectors that have been changed. How is this done? The magic word is checksums. I will execute the flash.reprogramAll command with the erase option. The command detects empty flash sectors and marks the sectors as follows. Not empty sectors are marked as pending. All empty sectors are marked as reprog. We can now download our executable using the data.load command or by selecting the menu File, Load File, then selecting the executable. This command detects which sectors need to be changed to program the selected file. Sectors that need to be reprogrammed are marked as pending. Finally, after hitting the off button or executing the flash.reprogram.off command, all flash sectors marked as pending are programmed with the new content. Afterwards, the marking is cleared. You can now see the code programmed in the flash. In case only selected sectors should be programmed, then you should specify the address range of these sectors as a parameter of the flash.reprogram command. Or do a right mouse click on the wanted sectors, then select Reprogram. Trace 32 marks the remaining sectors with NUP operation. After loading the ELF file, the in-range sectors are marked with pending, because their contents need to be reprogrammed. With flash.reprogram.off, all pending sectors are now reprogrammed. Please be aware that it is also possible to program several executables at a time before executing the flash.reprogram.off command. As a summary, a simple startup script for the STM32F373VC that uses a flash programming script provided by Lauterbach might look like this. The first part contains the commands for the board setup and setup of the debug communication. The second part contains the commands for the flash configuration. And this part contains the commands that program the flash. Afterwards, the device is reset, then we load the symbols. More details on the programming of processor internal flashes are provided by our documentation. The document norflash.pdf also includes information on the programming of external NOR flashes. Thank you for your attention.